so big! You're so big and wet! Where's your wet dog? Where's your wet dog? Oh, there you are! I'm being attacked! I'm being attacked! Right. Oh!
Why are we here on Friday?
Because we love our patients.
We do, because it's Christmas week.
Exactly.
Oh! Hi! Look who's there!
You!
Hi. We miss
I'm
you!
Alive.
You no home. More asthma, pneumonia.
No, I still have pneumonia.
But not contagious.
No,
I have
this walking. This is what they call walking pneumonia.
Yeah,
because
I don't
walking
know what's happening. I'm now packing up more stuff
you
than I'm
going.
No,
okay, I'm good. Chair.
I'm good.
All right.
She's a lot.
All right. All right. So we just went. Riley's due for doxo, CBC chem. Nini's here for blood work because her liver values were elevated.
Nini is kind of an interesting story. She went in for an emergency pyometra. So she's an intact dog. She's just 7 now. So she was about 6 and a half. Parents were, of course, out of the country, sort of a classic story. They were in Germany, and she went in for an emergency pyometra, which is when the uterus fills with pus, not uncommon in older dogs that are intact. And the surgeon wonderfully noticed that the stomach looked abnormal and biopsied, and it came back as a very uncommon tumor for dogs, gastric adenocarcinoma. So you don't see a lot of stomach cancer in dogs, and it's typically lymphoma, which is still a weird cancer to see in the stomach of dogs. That was in April. We got a biopsy, second opinion, confirmed the diagnosis, Colorado State, one of my favorite places. So why do I do a second opinion? You know, when you have an uncommon cancer, I think it's great to get a second set of eyes on the biopsy. So that's a great tip, guys. If your dog has an uncommon cancer or your cat and you're talking to your vet or your oncologist, it never hurts to get a biopsy, second opinion. They don't need to biopsy your dog again. They just have that biopsy sent to another lab and you get another set of eyes to look at the cells under the microscope. They confirmed the diagnosis and also saw lymphatic invasion. So cancer cells getting in the lymphatics, which I kind of consider like the subway, a route of metastasis or spread. She was doing really well. We were just coming up on 6 months of Palladia oral chemotherapy with low-dose metronomic cyclophosphamide, doing great. Chest x-rays and ultrasound had been negative throughout her treatment. And then we ran blood work a couple of weeks ago and her ALT, her liver value, was moderately elevated. We stopped the Palladia. It's not a common side effect, but it's possible that it was the Palladia. And unfortunately today her liver values are worsened. And so we're adding another medication. So we had added denimarin. Now we're adding some ursodiol, which promotes bile flow. And I'm sending her off to a surgeon to get laparoscopic biopsies. One of my least favorite words to say. What is laparoscopy? So instead of doing an abdominal incision, they are going to do little incisions and put micro cameras in, and they can get the liver biopsy that way. And that's a much better way to get liver biopsies than ultrasound guided liver biopsies, which have not been shown to be super accurate. So that's a recommendation for her. She's not eating. We gave her some Serenia today, and I have her on Serenia, Entyce, and mirtazapine because she's really not eating well. With her liver values going up, sadly, that makes sense. So we need a diagnosis for her. I don't think it's related to her cancer or her treatment, but we'll need a liver biopsy to figure that out. Maybe it's some sort of hepatitis or some other drug toxin. If it was the Palladia, I really would have expected to see improvement. She's been off the medications for 2 months. So that's about it for her, and we'll see who's next.
Leo.
Say hi, Leo.
Hi, handsome.
So Leo, he's an 8-year-old golden with lymphoma. So he is just a couple of weeks into his protocol. And he was one of those unusual dogs that got a low white blood cell count from vincristine. Not a typical drug to cause a low white blood cell count, but it's why we check white blood cell counts before we give any chemo drug. So we are going to lower the dose. 20%. So studies do show that if you lower chemo, you can lose efficacy. So we do walk a very fine line between keeping them in remission, which he is, and not causing such a low white blood cell count that they can get septic.
Look at that toe mass. Ouch.
Has this funny toe mass swelling going on, so I'm sticking a needle in that. And he's gonna get his chemo, and we're gonna start him on some antibiotics to cover him in case he gets a low white blood cell count. And for his toe, which to me looks infected and is probably unrelated to his chemo. When I squeezed on it earlier, pus was coming out of it. You know what I don't like?
Pus?
Pus.
Me either.
Pus is gross. That's why I'm gonna put on this, the glove. The glove. All right, stick a needle. Overall, Leo's doing well. He's in remission. That is the good sign, and his appetite's coming back, which is great. All right, guys, let's talk about MISHUK. So we have a kitty here that has lymphoma, and it's a weird place. It was in the lip upper gum area and responded really well initially to chemotherapy, to the CHOP protocol and radiation, but then relapsed. That's his lymphoma, which doesn't want to stay in remission. So we are actually going to stick a needle in it, which I've been wanting to do for weeks, but he hasn't been anesthetized and I'm not that mean. So we've had to adjust his protocol and I have him on something called MIVIP. So it's a mustergen vinblastine procarbazine protocol and we're giving him a little bit more radiation. So today he got another dose of radiation with the same chemotherapy protocol that I switched him to recently. And we actually aspirated the mass under anesthesia, which I'm gonna show you. And then that is gonna help us because he's responded to antibiotics and to chemo and I'm not sure if he has an infection, lymphoma, or both. So I figured while he's anesthetized for radiation, this would be a great opportunity to get some cells out of there, and we're sending that off to the lab. Oh, Benny is such a nervous mess. So you're only seeing him anesthetized today because he's also one of my patients that's getting radiation and chemo. He had an incompletely resected mast cell tumor. So this tumor was originally taken off May of this year, so about 7 months ago, but it came back about 4 months later. It was a bleeding mass. I sent it to one of my favorite surgeons in the area, board certified surgeon who's really good at soft tissue cancer surgeries. And it actually became a high grade tumor. So this one really morphed into something more aggressive with a higher mitotic index and higher proliferation scores. So we decided to do radiation to prevent it from coming back. He's gotten 4 doses of chemo. After his first one, we found a new mass and we're now radiating that as well. So about 10 to 20% of dogs with mast cell tumors will get a second mast cell tumor over the course of the life. A lot for Benny, but he's having a great quality of life and mom's really pleased with how he's doing. Jesse, I'm so proud of you. You are not neutropenic. You have a normal white blood cell count. Woo woo! So can I tell you how excited I am that Jesse had white blood cells? She is that unusual dog that got a low white blood cell count 2 times, once after Vinc, once after cyclophosphamide. Never done that before, and both times she required hospitalization for support for sepsis. So I lowered her Vinc and it worked and she's doing great. So she's due for doxorubicin, which is the most likely drug in the lymphoma protocol to cause chemotherapy side effects. So we made a decision to give her Vinc. Why? Because we know she tolerates it, and I just wasn't ready to give her doxorubicin. So we gave her a week to get stronger, not need any antibiotics, and then hopefully next week she'll get doxorubicin. The addition of doxorubicin for dogs with lymphoma really significantly improves survival time. We did talk about just doing Vinc and cyclophosphamide in PRED, which is called a COP protocol, but dogs that get doxorubicin, the CHOP protocol, do much better than dogs that don't. So that's the plan with her, and we'll see her next week. April belongs to an assistant I used to work with up in the Hudson Valley, and she is a very small, about 7 pounds, 13 and a half years old, Maltese mix, and she was diagnosed with lymphoma, and mom elected not to do the multi-agent protocol just due to cost and scheduling. She works, she has a young child as well, and so one of the other colleagues at the practice started with Tenovia, which is that new drug. Fortunately, it didn't work for her, so I gave her doxorubicin 2 weeks ago, and lymph nodes are about 50% smaller, so she has what we call a partial response, and I am going to probably recommend that we give another dose. Let's see if her blood work is okay. Perfect. And her platelets are good, so but I'm gonna recommend that she get another dose because her lymph nodes are smaller. We're giving treats.
Sorry.
No, that's okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, I want to go home. Okay, that's enough. Here. You take these in the car.
Thank you.
Put them in your pocket. That's how we make friends with the dog. All right. Love
Thank you.
You.
Love you and best.
Hope your daughter recovers well.
Thank you.
All right, we'll see you in 2 weeks.
We'll see you next time.
Better be in remission.
She
better be. And now I can't pick her up anymore, but I love you. Okay, say goodbye.
Say bye-bye.
Say TGIF.
TGIF. Woo-woo.